peace, power, and protection. I am Malik Heru El Shabbazz, the owner of Shabbazz Organics, ShabbazzCosmetics.com. Today, I'm going to discuss diabetes. Doesn't look like water, do it? It's all yellowish, gold. But it's a mix that I make to keep myself going. So, according to CDC, I'm jumping right into this. I'm not going to even fuck around and be talking about other stuff. I just want to go straight to it. According to CDC, diabetes is a chronic, which is long-lasting, health condition that affects your body, affects how your body turns food into energy. Most of the food you eat is broken down into sugar, also called glucose, and released into your bloodstream. When your body, when your blood sugar goes up, it signals your pancreas to release insulin. Insulin acts like a key to let the blood sugar into your body's cells for use as energy. If you have diabetes, your body either doesn't make enough insulin or can't use the insulin it makes as well as it should. When there isn't enough insulin or cells, stop responding to insulin, too much blood sugar stays in your bloodstream. Over time, that can cause serious health problems, such as heart disease, vision loss, and kidney disease. There isn't a cure yet for diabetes, but losing weight, eating food, healthy food, and being active can really help. Taking medicine as needed, getting diabetes self-management education and support, and keeping healthcare appointments can also reduce the impact of diabetes on your life. So that's what the CDC says diabetes is. I'm in the business of healing, curing, but I can't use those words when I am selling or putting out medicine, because the pharmaceutical industry, pharmaceutical industrial complex, had a lock on those terms to prevent herbalists and healers to prevent us from using words like that. But I'm an herbalist, and so I am in the business of using herbs to help people improve their life and increase their life span. So I'm going to be talking about what herbs you can use in this case for diabetes and the symptoms of diabetes, and what other how you can blend different herbs to be more effective for you. So the first thing I want to say is, when I'm talking about the symptoms, as I'm going down the line, you can check off these symptoms. But that doesn't mean that you have diabetes or any disease, because you hear a number of symptoms that you might have yourself. That doesn't mean you have diabetes. So don't get caught up in that. So the number one symptom, or the first sign of diabetes, is belly fat. Now, we have three types of belly fat. As far as I'm concerned, we have upper belly fat, we got lower belly fat, and we got all belly fat. All right, big old round belly fat. All right, so I'm talking about round belly fat. That's just like total all over belly fat. Your bottom belly fat is the same as your top belly fat, as the same as your middle belly fat. That's four. So belly fat. That's the first sign of diabetes. But if you have belly fat, it doesn't mean that you have diabetes or even pre-diabetic, but it's the first sign. Excessive hunger, just eating, always hungry, all right? Tired, weakness, blurred vision, frequent urination, eyes turn yellow or jaundice. Your cuts take longer to heal. You have frequent desire to drink water. You have numbness in the hands, or in particular the fingertips. You have numbness in your feet and in your legs. And of course, you have an increased blood sugar level. These are all symptoms of diabetes. Now, what herbs can I use to fight this diabetes or to reverse this diabetes? So diabetes is, according to the medical industry, is incurable. Now, you have some people who will, what I'm looking for is rebel against the industry, the medical industry, and say that they can, that diabetes is curable. If it's curable, it's curable. If it's not curable, it's not curable. Do I think it's curable? I think it's reversible. That's a safer word, and a more honest word. I think that it's reversible. And one of the most effective herbs that you can use in a wide array of herbs is Korean ginseng. Dymema, Indian kino, insulin plant. This other one is it's called what is this called? Laga Stromia speciosa, or giant crepe myrtle. These are the most effective herbs that you can use to reverse diabetes. But let me say this to anybody who might be listening. Whenever you take a medicine or an herb or anything that's going to help you get better, if you think that just taking the medicine is going to help you, and you don't change your behavior that got you to the point that you're at, then the medicine or the herb is not going to work as desired. So while you're taking the herb, you also have to change the way that you do things. Your lifestyle has to change, meaning that you need to be more active. In this case, for diabetes, you got to be more active. You have to eat more healthy. For those who understand that we are not just one individual body, but we are mental, spiritual, physical, and emotional body, that on all of these levels that we have to make changes for the better or the positive. And so it takes work. It's not going to just happen because you take the herbs. So now you have other herbs, though, that are effective. So these first herbs were highly effective. Now the effective herbs that you can take for diabetes would be, first of all, there's a lot of herbs that you can take. So I'm not going to go through all of them, but some of the more common herbs is water plantain, fig, bitter gourd, jackfruit, apple, fenugreek, Indian gooseberry or amla, mango leaf, sweet potato, barberry, artichoke, and then the most effective, baby watermelon, chia, fennel, garlic, curry leaf, cedarwood, bay leaf, astragalus, aloe vera, African mango, onion. So as you're cooking your food, there are certain vegetables and other organic food that you can incorporate into your diet that will help reverse diabetes. And then for those people who want to take supplements, herbal supplements, you can take the different stuff like astragalus, aloe vera, yarrow, rose hip. And then you even have stuff that's effective, like almond oil, argan oil, Arabica coffee, black pepper, bitter apple. I mean, there's over literally more than 100 or 200 different herbs you can take to reverse diabetes. But if you're taking the herbs and you get them into your body, you have to remember that you have to also have a lifestyle change. Now, if you have, there are certain things that you can also mess up some stuff too. So, say like people that's taking metformin, you know, you got if you're taking these herbs and you're taking metformin, you might experience your flushing of your skin, indigestion, abdominal, stomach pain, accumulation of gas, constipation, and diarrhea. Depends, constipation or diarrhea. You might have a loss of appetite. You might have nausea. So some of these herbs will contradict with some of the medicine that you might be taking. So metformin, you just have different interactions. So what causes diabetes? Diabetes is caused by stress. Anytime there's an illness, most of the time that illness is caused by stress. Stress is a fucking killer. Old age, anxiety, obesity, bad diet. Now, family history, which is a trick, worth the trick. I'm going to talk about that in a second. Lack of insulin. Insulin gene mutations, nutritional deficiency. Talk about that in a minute. Insulin receptor mutations and fatty foods and sugary foods. So let's talk about sugary foods. Sugary foods. Most people have sugar addiction. They don't realize they have sugar addiction. And so they like everything sweet. You know, it don't taste good unless it's sweet. And so the sugar industry is a powerful, powerful, powerful industry. It's the best drug dealer out there. So most food has sugar in it. And then I want you to understand something here. I'm going to Google this. How many names are there for sugar? Okay. There are 56 different names for sugar. So when you read in these ingredients on something, right, on something before you eat it, you want to look for the sugar, of course. But there's all types of sugar. I mean, there's all types of names that they use for sugar. And the FDA know this, right? And they let this trick play on words go. And then it doesn't, also when you look at these nutritional facts, you'll see something like percentages on the daily values. But then when it comes to sugar, you don't see a daily value. You don't see a daily value. And so a little sugar can be more than enough for your daily intake. But everything has sugar in it. And because of that, they don't put it on the thing. So you just eat a whole bunch of sugar. Anyway, dextrose, fructose, galactose, glucose, lactose, maltose, sucrose, beet sugar, brown sugar, cane juice crystals, cane sugar, castor sugar, coconut sugar, raw sugar, yellow sugar, brown rice syrup, caramel, fruit juice, honey, invert sugar, malt syrup, maple syrup, molasses, rice syrup, refiner syrup, sorghum syrup, treacle. Those, man, look, so much sugar out there, right? When you taking this stuff, when you eating stuff, you just eating sugar on top of sugar on top of sugar on top of sugar. And so we have learned or been conditioned to accept sugar as a value in what's good and what's not good. And so that leads to diabetes. Okay? Now, the other thing that I said was the nutritional deficiency. Okay, so nutritional deficiency. Most food that we eat is not even food. It's not even food. And so if it's not food and we eating it and we get full, but there's no nutritional value in it. So basically, we're full, but we're not even eating. It's a fucking trick. We're not even eating real food. We're eating food like stuff, but it's not food. And because it's not food, we're not getting nutritional value. And no nutritional value, we're starving ourselves. And so as a result, we end up with diabetes. So processed food. Food like dairy, food that has been pasteurized or enriched, white rice, white bread, white sugar, boxed stuff that can last for years on the shelf. They all are processed food. It's a lot of times made with stuff. If you understood that how some of this food is made, and they understand that it's made with stuff that the body shouldn't even have in it. And here's the thing about the human body. The body will bring in this stuff, and it will break it down and look for the nutrition in it so that it can use it. The other stuff, it's foreign to the body, and the body says the idea is supposed to be, well, the body's supposed to push it out. You shouldn't even have it in the first place. But the body's supposed to push it out. But the body don't do that. The body will hold on to that shit. And then you will get this. And you'll get this. Especially in men. A lot of food has estrogen in it. Right? And then men get man tits. You know, stuff that men like. Beer. Wieners and hot dogs and pizzas and shit like that. It has components of estrogen in it. And then foods that women like has components of testosterone in it. I don't know why they do that, but they do. And so the nutritional deficiency is because you're not really eating real food, right? Even when you go to these fast food restaurants, right? How is it that if you go to the store to buy all the ingredients for a hamburger, it's going to cost you $30, $40 for you to make hamburgers for your family? But then you can go to the fast food places and you can get a hamburger for 99 cents and it has all of the ingredients on it, right? Sometimes the lamb lettuce ain't even real lettuce. The cheese, it's not even cheese. It's something else. The meat isn't meat. It's something else. So, and we stopped cooking a long time ago for the most part. Most people don't want to cook. They just go out and eat because it's convenient, it's faster. And so they eat this stuff and they're starving themselves and they think that they're full, but they're not full because they're not really getting any nutritional value. They don't understand the definition of what full is. Full is when you have enough nutrients in your body that you don't have to put any more into your body, because your body won't even use it. Your body won't use what it needs, and then they'll shit out the rest. Everything else, you know, it uses and turns into glucose so that the body can use it. Everything else, it just shits it out. So when you're full, that means that your cells don't need any more nutrients. Not that you can't eat anymore and you're all fucked up like that. Then you have family history, all right? So people say that diabetes is genetic. I don't think that diabetes is genetic. I think that diabetes is cultural, all right? And what I mean by that is, if I grew up in a household where we ate soul food all the time, every year we had chitlins, every year we had a soul food meal, we eat constantly soul food, we constantly are eating with shit that is not that good for us, like lard, pork fats, and processed stuff. We eating that stuff, right? So our mom, grandmother gets diabetes, our dad gets diabetes, and then we grow, and then they pass on, and then we become adults. We eat what we are familiar with. We internalize what we grew up on. And as a result, we inherit that shit. But if you're a child and, you know, you eating that kind of stuff because that's what you have to eat, because that's what's available to you. But then when you become an adult and you change your diet and you start eating a better way, more than likely, you won't get diabetes. You won't get the diseases that your family got, because you change your habit, your lifestyle. It's not genetic like that. That's my opinion. Now, smarter people will, that can use better words and can, you know, dress that shit up, polish that turd and make it shine, will convince you that it is genetic. But in my opinion, it's not genetic. It's cultural. So, if you don't treat properly your diabetes, if you got diabetes and you don't treat it properly, glaucoma, gangrene. You got diabetes and you're not treating it right. You continue to eat bad and continue to just stuff your face full of that stuff, whatever, right? Bad food. Inactive lifestyles. Gangrene is when you notice in your toe you got black spot, brown spot, red spot, that basically is saying that it is dying. That part of the body is dying, and so if it's becoming toxic, poison, and so what happens is the doctor's got to cut it off. It happens in your toe, then it happens in your foot, then it happens in your leg, then it happens in your arm, or you go blind, and all this kind of stuff like that. That's gangrene. All right? So if you don't treat the diabetes, gangrene happens. Alzheimer's happens. Heart disease, kidney failure, diabetic, cardiovascular disease, necrosis of an extremity, all right, which is kind of what the gangrene is. You know, you get the dead ends, whatever, just start to die off, and it's like here soon your whole arm is gone. If you get cut and it don't heal fast enough, you know, normally, or don't clot up and start to heal, then the reason why I can't say certain words right now is because I have a bad tooth. I have an abscess. I'm trying to get to the dentist so I can get it out. And so some of my words, I can't say them because it actually hurts to say them. But anyway, so I apologize if I say a word that you know what it is and I know what it is, but I can't say it because it's painful. diabetic retinopathy, or retinal damage, meaning, you know, you having bad eyes, right? Look, diabetes is a bad malady, all right? And if you have diabetes, there are some herbs that you should avoid, okay? Or some natural stuff that you should avoid. One of them is alcohol. Carbohydrate-rich food, sour beverages, sugarcane juice, rhizome root, curd, potatoes, and ghee from the butter. That part of the butter, you should avoid it. Now, here's the funny thing. Your body, the diabetes is like, that's what I want. I want that shit, man. So it's creating these appetite in you to want it. But you got to resist it because you're the master of the body. So you got to resist it. If you want to do something good for your body, then incorporate turmeric, gooseberry, barley, wheat, pepper, garlic, blueberry, and exercise. If you can do that, those things will help in you reversing your diabetes. Exercise, keep that heart rate going. Keep your body, force that body to ignite or turn on, force them cells to move, you know, get them in motion and push that diabetes back or push it out. Now, you know, if you are heading toward diabetes, you know, the body sends you signals that something goes wrong. You think your belly fat is without a reason? Nope. Belly fat is the first symptom of diabetes. Don't wait for blood sugar. Find some herbs to bring that belly fat down. Find some activity that you like. Some people like yoga because they don't want to exercise. They don't like that lactic acid feel or burn after being working out. So they go to yoga. Some people go work out, some people walk, some people run, some people fast, meditate, whatever it is that you need to do, get this shit off you, okay? Let's see, what else I want to talk about here? It's a lot to this. It's a lot of moving parts to diabetes. And the most common body parts that is affected is the pancreas, which creates the insulin, and then the metabolism. Your metabolism is, so bigger people feed their diabetes. Skinny people starve their diabetes, or the diabetes start to eat them from the inside because they are not feeding the diabetes. So your metabolism and your pancreas. Now, funny thing is, when you feed the diabetes and you're big, right, the diabetes can cause you to not want to eat as much. Or maybe it's the medication or whatever, but most of the people that have diabetes that I help say that they don't eat as much as they used to eat. And it's probably because of the medication, the pharmaceutical stuff. But the bigger ones say that. The smaller people don't say that. So some of the metabolism diseases that you will see in people with diabetes, one of them is cellulite. Right? Cellulite is, you see the people that have that kind of fat that just, you know, do this right here, and having their legs and their feet, it's just that jangly fat, right? And so that's one of the diseases. Gout is another disease. Stuff like Hodgkin's disease, high cholesterol, obesity, Wilson disease, night sweat, magnesium deficiency, lead poisoning. Man, as far as your metabolism is concerned, you have so many different diseases that can happen because of, if I say that right, because of diabetes. There's so many different metabolism-related diseases that can occur in the body. And then you have pancreas diseases, abdominal diseases, alcoholism, pancreatitis, pancreatic cancer, hypoglycemia, gestational diabetes. So what we want to do is we want to reverse this shit. And so by reversing it, you want to start walking, start running, go work it out, get on that iron, get on the treadmill, do some calisthenics. Calisthenics is exercise without weights. All right. Use your own strength or your own body to like push-ups, sit-ups, jumping jacks, running in place, squats, stuff like that. That's calisthenics. Twists, bends, stretching, you know, this is calisthenics. Swimming, calisthenics. Do something. Keep that body in motion, right? Then change your eating habits. Change your drinking habits, you know. Try to find alkaline water. Try to incorporate alkaline foods. Try to eat less meat. No dairy. No processed foods. Am I saying become a vegetarian or vegan or pescatarian? I'm saying to you to stop eating meat, red meats or raw meats or hardly cooked, uncooked, undercooked meats. Number one thing is stop feeding the diabetes with the sugar. So the best sugar for you is going to be the organic sugar, natural sugar that comes in fruits and vegetables, grains, stuff like that. Okay, I think I covered everything, and I didn't mean to go fucking 30 minutes into this thing. I just wanted to kind of, you know, hit it. But anyway, if you have diabetes or if you are pre-diabetic, especially if you're pre-diabetic, you have the opportunity, a better opportunity to reverse that and pull back from it. But once you become diabetic, then it becomes a little harder, more difficult for you to come back. Fight the urge to eat the shit that caused diabetes. Fight it. You be hungry at night, you be wanting to eat some shit, eat apples. Drink apple juice. Real apple juice, not apple flavored juice or flavored drinks, none of that shit. Leave that alone. The good sugar is in the stuff that nature makes for us. So, I make at Shabbazz Organics, I make three or four different types of remedies for people with diabetes to help them get the nutrients that they're not getting or they should be getting in the food, and help them reverse this shit. So you can go to ShabbazzCosmetics.com, or you can give me a call, of course, 832-267-4495. You can email me at shabazzcosmetics.com@gmail.com. It's all one email. And I can get you lined up. All right. Not only me, but a good herbalist will get you lined up. If you can't reach me or you know somebody that's an herbalist, ask them what type of herbs they have for diabetes and if they can make you a good blend. Not a general blend that everybody uses, but something more custom to you, because you might be on some medication that another person with diabetes is not on, and the herbs that they use for that person might actually hurt you or not be effective for you because of the medication that you're on. So you want a custom diabetic blend that's made specifically for you. That's the herbalist's job, is to do that kind of thing. So anyway, you got my information. Do what you got to do. Be careful out there and be mindful. Help yourself. Peace and blessings.